Round 14. Final round of the year got off to a shaky start for the first 11 after being sent into bowl, realising that keeper Burgess did not have his cricket bag with him.
We're good, streaky! Yes! We're going streaking through the quad and into the gymnasium. Come on, everybody! Hey, honey. Hey.
What the hell are you doing?
You're streaking. Hey.
Looks like it's a little cold out there, huh?
But once on the field, the boys fought hard with wickets from Buckets and Nugget keeping Norwood to 255. Unfortunately, 50 from Mooney and 40 from Ellis was not enough, as they both fell short in the finish to the year. The game also marked the end of an era, with life member Anne Pascoe ending her magnificent 43-year scoring stint. Thanks, Annie. Finishing the season against Warrandyte at home, the twos bowled first and restricted the top side to 197 with a strong bowling effort. Brando threw up and returned to the bowling crease to take two wickets, and Russian, Ben and Chris Jackson each took one, whilst Dutch took five wickets for himself. Benny Jay departed early on day two and quick wickets fell. Flush 55, the only top order score of importance. Brando's quick fire 34 and Russian's 19 down the lower order had us in with a chance, but we were all out for 177.
Hello darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again. Because a vision softly creeping.
The game was noteworthy with all three Jacksons playing in the same team for the first time. The threes were back on the dust bowl that is East Ringwood number two, needing an outright. Hoiberg was summoned for his second over of the season right before the tea break and sure enough managed to claim the wicket of East Ringwood's in-form opener, only to have the delivery adjudicated as a no ball, leaving the outgoing Prez with season figures of 2 for 2 off two. You could not make this stuff up. Havers posted a career best 62 to cap off the threes win in the final game of the season.
The king in the north. The king in the north. King in the north.
Relieved they weren't playing Moorabbin, the fours had St Andrews reeling at 9 for 52. Then ISO had an idea. Give Kleinie a bowl. His over went for 21, and we ended up bowling out St Andrews for 87. ISO, the pick of the bowlers, with a hat-trick and 6 for 12. Unlike his previous 6 for, he may actually get some votes in this game. ISO is the fourth pixel from the right. The batting was fairly cavalier, with highlights being 45 from Wardy and 36 not out from Darren Wellesley, featuring some quick boundary hitting. We declared after 23 overs to reach 3 for 110 and picked up two late wickets on day one to set up a good chance of an outright, dismissing them for 156, leaving a chase of 134 at just 4 and over. The boys got it done in plenty of time to spare, Dan Wellesley coming in late to score quickly and get them over the line. Rohan booted Drew to the sevens after he was mean to his sister, and the fists were left in the capable hands of Tarn and Rakesh to provide some flair. Rockstar hitting from Pete Manson, and with Rohan finally making double figures, the Dites batting card looked promising at tea. Things got so awkward after tea, felt like Campbell and ISO were alone together. Sharon snared a key wicket with a well-disguised slower ball, leaving him three overs short of the bowling award. The Sixers won the toss but were forced to bat first, given that only seven players had made it to the ground on time. Warrandyte battled to be 5 for 162, with Jarrah Aitken out for 24 and off early to a party, and Cal Lawson making 22. Star of the batting was Bailey Thomas, sitting on 78 not out, with Captain Stubbs also unbeaten at the end of week one. The spreadsheet showed danger, danger on their opener, but Stubbs sorted him out for 14. But then, week two, when the cricket gods smiled upon the Warrandyte 6-11, friends were made at the Bureau of Meteorology and the game was heated off for a draw. Cricket was alive and well again. The Sevens batted first in a do-or-die clash against Norwood, with Drew Chocolate Masali hacking his way to 94 not out, but not before Rob Fyfe top-edged a ball straight into his eye. This game also saw the return of Mitch Gaffney to the club, starring with 7 wicketless overs on the little ground. Wickets to Dale and Sproat saw the game slightly out of reach for the Sevens before Simon decided it was too hot to play the following week, ending any slim hope of finals. Round 14.